Law enforcement sources are saying the FBI has now identified at least 12 terrorists who were on the doomed flights, at least three on each of the four hijacked planes. Some of them may have crossed into the state of Maine from Canada. In Boston, FBI and police SWAT teams stormed two hotels, including the Westin downtown, where they reportedly detained one man. This after reports police found a rental car at Logan Airport laden with Arabic language flight training manuals. In Venice, Florida, the owners of a flight training company say agents told them two men who trained to be small plane pilots last summer are suspects.
I wouldn't have any idea about what they, you know, what their reasons would be. But I could tell you that, that at this flight school, they would not be able to learn how to fly one.
What about steer one?
Steer one, possibly.
In Coral Springs, one of the suspects may have lived in this apartment. Searches are underway in other parts of Florida as well. In North Texas, agents are tight-lipped about the investigation here.
I can't answer that question this time.
No arrests or searches in Texas, but agents are questioning anyone with any possible link to Osama bin Laden, the billionaire Egyptian now suspected of being behind the attacks. And bin Laden has had connections to North Texas in the past. Wadi El-Hajj of Arlington, who purportedly worked as a used tire salesman in Fort Worth, was convicted in the twin bombings of U.S. embassies in Africa several years ago. Prosecutors described El-Hajj as a one-time personal secretary to bin Laden. And now, agents in Texas confirm they're actively looking for another purported bin Laden associate, Moataz Al-Hallak, a shadowy figure who prosecutors claim has helped bin Laden set up front companies and even at one time bought a jet for bin Laden that later crashed.
Yes, I'll tell you that. Yes, we are looking for Moataz.